boy. Sure is a good day to go skating. Oh, hi, I didn't know you were here too. Why, that makes it perfect now that everyone's here. Who's that? I gotta find out. Hello. Who are you? I'm Big Bird.
Nice to meet you, Big Bird. My name's Geri Jewell.
Yeah, hey, you know, you talk differently. Where are you from?
I was born in the United States, but I was also born with cerebral palsy. That's probably why I talk this way. Oh. Well, see you later.
Later, but wait. I just wanted to ask you, how come you move differently, too?
That's from the same condition, cerebral palsy.
Oh.
It makes it harder for me to move.
Well, you're sure doing great for somebody with cerebral palsy.
Well, just because I do things differently doesn't mean I don't do them at all.
Oh.
Well, gotta go, Big Bird.
Hey, can I skate with you?
Sure.
Oh, boy, let's go.
Come on.
No way. Forget it, buddy. You're not going to win this one. Nah, way. You're going too slow. Look at you dropping him. Look, you drop him. No way. No way. Forget it. No, not this time. No. Oh.
2,475. Okay, Geri, beat that.
That's easy. Come on. That's
no
easy.
No problem.
Yeah, we'll see.
I love computer games. Because I have cerebral palsy, working with the joystick helps improve my coordination and reflexes.
Go. Look at that. Petey, you're lost, man. This is it. This is it. Finally, someone's going to beat you.
Yeah.
Now look at that. Every single apple. Every single one. You get that?
Oh, man.
Yeah. That about does it.
Yep. She beat you, man.
I can see, David. Geri, you're the first person to beat me in this neighborhood. Hey, I thought you said you only played to get your reflexes faster.
That's true. But I also play to win.
So.
Oh, no. This is terrible. I feel so embarrassed. I dropped my sandwich on the ground.
You shouldn't feel embarrassed, Telly. Lots of little kids have trouble eating without dropping food on the ground.
They do?
Sure, it just takes practice.
Oh, you're just saying that to make me feel better.
No, I'm not. It was even harder for me when I was a little kid because of cerebral palsy.
Oh, come on. You just don't want me to feel so bad.
No, it's true. When I was 2 years old, my mom had to tape the spoon to my hand so I could get the food to my mouth and not on the floor.
Really?
Yeah. My family had to be really patient and teach me how to eat because they knew eventually that I'd learn how to get it to my mouth. But there was one member of the family that didn't want me to learn how to eat, that wanted me to drop food on the floor, and that was my dog.
Really? How come your dog didn't want you to learn how to eat and keep on dropping your food on the ground?
Take a look, Telly.
Huh? Look. Oh, I get it. Your dog ate every time you dropped something on the ground, just like Barkley here. That's funny, Geri. Not filling, but funny.
Oh, Telly, here, have half of my sandwich.
Oh, thanks, Geri.
You're welcome.
You like the sandwiches I made for you?
Yeah.
Oh, that's good. It's nutritious.
Ladies and germs, boys and squirrels, I, Big Bird, am here to present the brand new game you can all play called Clues on a Clothesline.
Clues on a Clothesline.
Clothesline.
Yeah, you want to play?
But what's clues on a clothesline?
Well, up here, you see, a clothesline.
Oh.
Comes out of Bob's apartment.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Now, you're going to see some clues coming out on that clothesline when I say. And you have to guess who's putting the clues on the clothesline. Whoever it is up in the apartment. Okay?
Okay, this is a game.
See if you can guess who's up.
Fun.
Okay, all here's right. The first clue. Ta-da!
What is that?
A barn.
A barn.
What kind of barn? What's in a barn? A horse?
A chicken?
A chicken?
A chicken? What else?
Okay, no more guessing, because here comes another clue. What about that? What is
milk.
It?
Milk.
Milk.
Okay, so whoever is in Bob's apartment has something to do with a barn or with what else?
No.
Could it be a rabbit?
No.
No.
I doubt it. Okay, here's another clue.
This is hard. Okay, come on.
C? Oh,
letter C.
Whoever's in Bob's apartment has something to do with what?
A C.
And what else?
And
a barn. And what
milk.
Else?
Milk.
It's a chicken.
Well,
wait.
There's one more clue. And here it is.
Is this hard?
Yeah.
Wow.
That's what you'll hear from who's up ever up there.
No, not
well, maybe it's a cow. But a cow didn't say bow wow.
No, dog does.
Bow, wow.
Woof, woof.
Bow, wow.
Yes, it can be a cow if the cow is Gladys.
Bow, wow.
You know what? When I was a little kid, I wanted to be a comedian when I grew up. Have you ever thought about what you wanted to be when you guys grew up?
Yeah.
What do you want to be?
I think I want to be an artist.
An artist. That's neat. How about you, Justin?
I'll be a doctor.
You're going to be a doctor?
Yeah.
Good.
Gosh.
I'll
you want to be, Shay?
I want to be a ballet dancer.
A ballet dancer. That's exciting. Do you dance a little bit now? What do you want to be, Eric?
I want to be a policeman.
You going to pull me over and give me a ticket?
No.
Big Bird.
Yeah? I know what I want to be.
What do you want to be?
I want to be like you. I want to be a comedian when I grow up. And I want to stand up there in front of a microphone and tell jokes. Why, listen to this. Oh, this is good. You're going to like... wait till you hear this. Wait. No, wait. Why did King Kong climb up the outside of the Empire State Building?
I don't know. Why?
Because he was too big to use the elevator. I think I'll get the job.
Well, when do you expect to grow up?
Not for quite a few years yet.
Oh, you're great, no matter what. I love you. Isn't he neat? In spite of his coming job.
Hi, everybody.
Hi, Bert.
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters D and I and by the number 2. Thank you. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.